Hello everyone, tank update, where to begin? Last update was probably shortly after a wipeout where I lost everything with the exception of the inverts, the cleaner shrimp. You can see them here over the rocks, and this yellow ras, which is as robust as can be. I've since set up a quarantine tank and I've got some new fish in there. They're under observation right now, making sure they're feeding, and then I'll run them through some treatments to ensure that they're not harboring any kind of diseases or parasites or anything of the nature. Oh my goodness, what have I added? Well, here, just a general display here. It's midday, the lights are on bright. You can see the Cinerina coral here is fully inflated. She's just looking great. What I've also added very recently is the orange Ricordia right here. I really love the texture of the Ricordia mushroom. Real happy with that. The toadstool forest is doing well, fully open. You can also see the torch coral is unfurled and flailing in the water. I'm assuming everything is happy. I just did a 20% water change yesterday. I've been using reef crystals, which I'm happy with, and maybe a water change every 3 weeks. And I just started to incorporate German salt, maybe a 1-to-4 ratio of the German salt to reef crystals, HD Marine Mix. I believe that's the name of the German salt. Just adding that in there, I figure it could add other trace elements that might be helpful and vital for some of the corals and the coral growth. Talking about coral growth, the Montipora digitalis, it's really branching out. You can see new growth at the tips here. I'm happy with that. I've also got this Ponape bird's nest, ORA frag, and just recently moved that out. It seems to be doing well. The potato chip Pavona coral is an ORA frag as well, and that was moved up as well. I can see it is growing, and I'm hoping it'll like the proximity to light. The cluster of, well, these are peppermint. Now, are these candy cane? These guys here, I'm really liking them, how they're doing and how they look. I'm a big fan. Got a Tridacna clam, which is here. It's already anchored itself on the rock. And here I've got a little colony of acro. And the mistake I made with this is I put it elsewhere in the tank where it was partially shielded by the rock, and I started getting some bleaching on the right side. I recently moved it out here more so under the direct light. I'm hoping it'll do okay. A little bit more of a challenge for me here. Still getting acquainted with the management and safekeeping of the corals in general. The green mushroom, I've moved this around a few times. It doesn't seem like it likes the flow that it gets in many spots of the tank. I'm hoping it'll do okay here. And the hammerhead down here had a problem here, in fact, and I noticed like a little corkscrew coming out of the base of this. And then as I looked throughout the tank, I noticed in a few areas a little snail. It has been known to be a problem. Forget what it's called, but there's a great identification guide online I found. And it's a snail where at the base it's a snail, and then it will create a, like a tube. It's all very hard material. And apparently it was irritating this hammerhead. I removed it, and I see that little snail elsewhere in the tank. I've read some reviews and user forums, others having problems with it being a pest, hard to remove, very sharp, and just trying to keep it away from any of the corals, such as not to disturb them. All right, the acan seems to be doing well right here. So three polyp, three head acan. The island of Xenia, it seems to be bushing out and growing. I had some bubble algae here at the base on that frag, which I siphoned out. Hopefully I got all of it and didn't release any spores in the tank. Got the pink Goniopora over here. I'm hoping it's doing well. I like it a lot. We'll see how it does. We've got the Duncan over here. Up in the back, I've got the green star polyp. And I think that covers it here. I got the little rock anemone down here, which has kept its little place here since I placed it there. I have added, what is it, five Trochus snails, which seem to be doing a great job. I had a big problem up at the top of the rock, closest to where the light is, with a very fine brown hair algae. And I had to reduce or remove the light for a few days. And I've also worked very hard to siphon it all out. And it seems like the majority of it's gone. I would see the hermits up in there grazing, the hermit crabs. And the Trochus snails, I believe they did some work in there as well. You can see one of the Trochus snails coming up in the back here on the back wall. But I like those Trochus a lot. They seem to be doing a good job. Real interesting, I see a hermit crab was climbing on the shell of one, and the snail twisted or shook real fast back and forth and knocked that hermit crab right off its shell. Very interesting. So I'm enjoying the tank. For the most part, it's fish-free, with the exception of this yellow wrasse, as I observe and medicate and then slowly introduce the other fish mates. Eventually it'll become a little bit more of an aquarium here. Meanwhile, I'm just watching the corals, observing them, testing the water parameters, hoping that everything is starting to grow. I opted to start with small frags and test my abilities to keep these alive and growing instead of going for the big frags right off the bat. I think I'll enjoy the process of growing them more than starting with a big frag. So I hope this update was interesting, and I look forward to providing more in the future. Thanks very much for watching.